It's a beautiful day here at Pallekelle, and welcome to all our viewers on www.thepapare.com, Sri Lanka's number one sports hub, bringing you live action from the Trinity College Rugby Stadium in Pallekelle. Dinuk, joining me is Dinuk Bhaskar. And Dinuk, this is going to be an interesting game. A bitter rivalry between these two schools, and this has come as the second game of the season for both of them.
Yeah, absolutely. Good evening, all of you. On your screens is the big game on a Sunday evening here in Pallekelle. Trinity College taking on Isipathana College. I think one of the...
Absolutely. A lot of rivalry needs to be settled here. It feels 28, partly cloudy. A nice wind blowing across the ground. So playing conditions are ideal for nice and fast open rugby that we witnessed between the two teams. Well, what we'll do now is we'll go for a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we will have plenty to talk about.
To be a man is to sweat for every last inch of it. The harder you push yourself, the louder your body will protest. From sweat to grease, grease to dandruff. Fight back with Clear Men, two times the fighting power of ordinary shampoos. Beat grease, beat dandruff. Unbeatable performance for the unbeatable man. Power through the odds. Clear, zero dandruff, nothing to hide.
Sri Lankika Samage Therima, no limit.
Drift in search of happiness. Fashion inspired by emotion. Glitz, the fashion destination. Sri Lankika Samage Therima, no limit.
When she's special, she's not just a girlfriend. She is your sweetheart. When you feel it, you don't just call it sunshine. You call it warmth. When you reveal your deepest emotions, it's not just art. It's freedom. And when its essence is premium cocoa butter, it's not just chocolate. It's Ravello. Chocolate so special, you call it Ravello.
Then Gold Dio Body Spray. Hatunwadin Alut Marit Madili Atrakin. Blaze, Challenge, Storm Sahar Rave. Adamatrai Karana. Gold Dio Body Spray. Pevis Yatrapura.
දැන් යහපෝෂ හදන්නේ ඉරිඟු සහල් මුං සෝයා විතරක් නෙවෙයි කිරිත් එකතු කරලා. ඒ නිසා මා චේන්ජ් වුණා.
ලංකාවේ ළමයින්ගේ අලුත්ම සොයා ගැනීම. මේක රසයක. බැලිබන් යහපෝෂ රසයකට චේන්ජ් වෙන්න.
The pinnacle of school cricket. The journey to glory. The road to greatness. March Madness 2019. From 1st March to 6th April, live on channel number 77 and Dialogue Now, channel number 1 on your Dialogue Television.
The choice of every Sri Lankan, no limit.
Crunchy Munchy.
Fiery Kochi.
Crescent Kochi Bites. Try it. Love it. The original Kochi Bites only from Crescent.
வெடிதியுனு டோக்கியோ சூப்பர் ஓனவரக்கட சூப்பர்
කිසි ගැම්මක් නෑ පදම පරක්කු ඇයි
සුමීරි පානේ පදමට ගහලා දවස පුරා ගතට දැන්නෙන මිහිරක් බුබුදා
හොඳම මැලිබන්තේ
කහට පදම නියමෙට රස සමග මුසුනා මැලිබන්තේ එක්ක අපේ දවස රස වුණා
පදම වරුනේ
කහට පදම නියමෙට රස සමග මුසුනා
මැලිබන්තේ පදමට කහට
Stumble upon a surprise, fashion inspired by emotion. Glitz, the fashion destination.
දැන් යහපෝෂා දන්නේ ඉරිඟු සහල් මුං සෝයා විතරක් නෙවෙයි කිරිත් එකතු කරලා ඒ නිසා මා චේන්ජ් වුණා
ලංකාවේ ළමයින්ගේ අලුත්ම සෝයා ගැනීම මේක රසයක බැලිබන් යහපෝෂ රසයකට චේන්ජ් වෙන්න
සතුට බෙදන නම
ඔබ ළඟ රැඳි නම
සනසුමදන නම
ඒ සිංග
පවුලට සතුට සදන සිඟ අති විශිෂ්ට විශ්වාසය
Welcome back as the school crowd have just changed stadiums from two hard days of big matches played between St. Anthony's and Trinity at the St. Anthony's College grounds to Pallekelle. Second 15 game just finished in favour of Isipathana, 17 points to 14. And this is something special, isn't it, Sudarshana, that we always see at a Trinity Isipathana game.
Absolutely, Dinuka. Both teams fight it really hard on the field, but once it's done, it's all about the camaraderie. Both teams have been known to do that, and this is what rugby is all about, isn't it? The game played in heaven, they say. And even at the sidelines, you can see the two set of coaches having a good chat. All of them have played club rugby against each other. Sali Kumar for Trinity College, Dinesh Chaturanga and Prasad Madhushankar for Isipathana College being the coaches of the second 15 units. It's a very important game for the Trinity second 15 because this is one of the few games that they get to put their hands up and show the management at the first 15 level that they also can make a mark. This today's game and this is what happened last week. Isipathana versus St. Thomas's versus St. Peter's. Petrides got onto an early lead, 14 points to nil in the first half, but what a comeback it was in the second half by the Thomians, showcasing the Thomian grit. This was the momentum that they carried forward to the Battle of the Blues. The cricket team notching up their first victory in 12 years, beg your pardon, and Josephians took on the lads from Mount Lavinia Science College in their opening fixture. St. Joseph's had a dominant first half, but it was all Science in the second half. Full-time score, 20 points to 14.
Isipathana College came out strong against a young St. Anthony's team and scored another 30-pointer in their season opener. Would have given a lot of confidence. And today is going to be one such matchup that Isipathana will want to come on top, whereas Trinity also will want to come on top to put up mark on the schools league. Trinity played their season opener down in Colombo. They would like to be happy here at the Pallekelle grounds. It's their home ground. They won that season opener down in Colombo, and they will want to win this as well. Playing as a unit, Trinity, 22 points to 11. And then Royal, who looked favorites from the first game onwards. It's going to be a big clash for the Bradby this time around, because Trinity is not an outfit that will go down bowing this time. They're strong, they're together. So it's going to be one hell of a Bradby. It's the 75th as well. 62 points to 6. That's how that finished against Malia Deva.
And Appian Candy, Eli Blasi Trophy, was kept hold by the Kingswoodians. Wesley putting up a real fight, but came up short against the spirited Kingswood outfit. 17 points to 12, they took the victory. And we are back here live on www.thepapare.com, bringing you pictures from the opening ceremony, or the official introduction of Trinity College versus Isipathana. Here's the footage of the last encounter both these schools played against each other, which is played at Havelock Park. Trinity got onto the scoreboard first, getting a try to their name, but what a strong comeback it was from the Isipathanians to square things up. 14 points all, and plenty of rivalry, unfinished business from last year will be carried forward to this year. They know, can I'm sure we will be able to witness a brilliant spectacle.
Yeah, for sure. Half time it was 6-12, but then Isipathana came back to score 12 all. One of those try scorers for that in that game, Trinity, was Mahdi Abdullah, who is playing his first game this year. Will come off the bench later on. We'll take a look at the team card. Here's the team introduction to the sponsors of Trinity College, the principals of both schools, and the committees, chairman of both schools and the POGs.
Starting 15 for Trinity, Nimesh Ekanayak, Dulara Agalavatta, Pabasara Munasinghe, Chetia Panavela, Megan Yaswant, Zaid Faisal, Direndra Ratwatte, Rahul Dhanaraj, Tehan Karunanayake, and Minidu Jayasundara has been the preferred halfback combination for this year for Trinity. Amit Kulatunga is on the wings alongside Geshap Kulatunga, and in the centre combination, Tevin Karunanayake and Shyam Robinson, with Reshan Bandar Naik at the back. Replacements for Trinity, Nandi Sen and Tenukon Abdullah, Tantrige Panavela, Vimal Samarasinghe, Herat Subasinghe, and Morogoda. And for the Greens, who will be taking up Trinity College, they have some experience in their midst, in the likes of Varnapura. We have Nirmal Disanayake, Gautam Dodangoda, Janit Serasinghe, Pandita Vikramarachi, Kalhara, and Renuja Silva will be a very, very key matchup here. And Nadish Chaminda and Ramit De Silva will be in the wings with Manilka Rubiru, their most experienced man, last year's captain. Also manning up the center mark with Manul Ratnayake and Ashan Gunasekar at the back. For replacements, we have Siharsha Bandara, Kaushalya, Akta, Rajapaksa, Ratnavira, Basik, Kodagoda, Stefan, and Javid.
Yeah, Manil Karuberu has plenty of experience in that green shirt for Isipathana College, and he will want to put up a show today. This is the game that he would have been looking forward to this season starting off.
standing for the school songs of both schools.
Well, after the two school songs, here we are, all ready for this intense battle between these two institutions, and a pleasant surprise, Trinity opting to go with their full school song rather than the first verse and the chorus dinner, a change we would hope to see in the coming games as well. And the match officials for today, Rohan Fernando alongside Ishan Kabekun and Gihan Yatavara as his assistants. Brilliant atmosphere and a brilliant climate, isn't it, Dinuk? So early in the season for these teams to be matched up is incredible. Nothing will be left as they leave the field. They will be determined to empty their tanks, both these set of players. Isipathana to kick off from right to left of your screens with the halfback Kalhara handed the duties of kicking and starting the proceedings for the green machine.
Kickoff goes down to Gishapa Kulatunga, flirting with the touchline, and goes into contact deep inside the Trinity half. The kickoff was made. Tehan,
number one,
off the base. Dangerous kick to hand for Isipathana. Yes, the counter attack coming up early on, spreading it wide. Manilka Ruberu cutting back in. Takes about two players, still going, offloads to Sera Singer. Has ample space. Sera Singer comes out wide to Isipathana once again. This time stepping off. And a lovely offload and a knock forward.
Well, this could very well be the one that got away. Isipathana early exchanges looking very threatening, like Dinuk rightly mentioned. Tehan that time guilty of kicking that ball right to the hands of the Isipathanians. And we all know how lethal Isipathana can be in their counters. But the finishing touch is not coming through for Isipathana. Trinity will look to clear their ranks straight away from here. Very important scrum this. The first scrum of the game. Trinity in a defensive 5-meter scrum.
Set. No movement. No movement. Steady.
Tehan Karunana got to put in, but referee Fernando is not happy with the formation of the scrum. And a big welcome to all our viewers who are joining us now on www.thepapare.com. Pictures coming to you live from the Trinity College Rugby Stadium here at Pallekelle. You haven't missed much as Isipathana put Trinity under tremendous pressure. Good pressure in the scrum. Dhanaraj almost clashing with his flank forward. Just maybe broke off from the wrong side of the scrum there. Now Trinity with the clearance. Yet again into the hand. Amit Kulatunga quickly up and running through the corners. Into the 5-meter line again. Trinity guilty of not finding touch twice in a row. And will they be made to pay? We will have to wait and see. Isipathana coming through their forwards, and that's a very good defensive performance by the Trinitians. They would have been in real trouble otherwise. Isipathana will definitely be ruining these early chances. Given away.
Yeah, if you kick, you have to kick deep inside Sudarshana. Because Isipathana's counter-attack has always been a threat for other teams. And you, as long as you starve ball of these Isipathana backs, it's going to be more trouble. Trinity can make the game easy and more, create more trouble for Isipathana. Couple of knock forwards giving away position. Trinity very lucky to stay at this moment scoreless.
Here's Big Dhanaraj breaking away. He has been a revelation so far this season after his performance against Zaira College. Now Janidu, this time around, finally manages to find touch. Not ideal, but it's out. So the Trinitians will take it. The two the two kickers who've been handed the responsibility of doing the clearance work for Trinity need to settle down. They are under a little bit of pressure now. Isipathanians, on the other hand, will look to make sure that they get their offloading right, cut out on the unforced errors, because otherwise there should have been at least 10 points up. Patana just outside the 22 meters. Opting to go with a five-man line out. Easy ball, Trinity not contesting. Isipathana sending it wide quickly. Quick hands, he is running through. Nadish Sharminda into the 22 meters. Isipathana looking threatening every time they have possession. Good work done by Amit Kulatunga that time, rushing up in defense, cutting out space. Another loss forward by Isipathana. Referee playing advantage. Trinity managing to hold on to it. It's the first time they've had proper possession. Quick ball coming out. Forwards doing the hard work for Trinity currently. They have options on both either side of the field. Tehan to Janidu. Janidu puts the ball to boot. Yet again, not finding touch. The fullback was right underneath it. Now Janidu has a free rein to put the ball out, but yet again, not an ideal kick, isn't it? Into the hands. They need to spread out wide. The Trinity defense, they are bogged on to the short side and penalized. So Trinity guilty of not clearing the ranks in these early exchanges. On the other hand, Isipathana have been finding it difficult to complete their passes. Would have their coaches ripping their hair out.
Minindu is kicking against the wind, so Darshana, that's why he's not finding touch. Twice he has gone to the far side of the ground, whereas he's playing against the wind, but it's a crosswind coming towards from the far side scoreboard towards the stadium. So Minindu has to use that wind if he has to clear to touch. A couple of times Trinity have kicked, it has swirled in the wind against and come in place of Isipathana. Isipathana back three are very good under the high ball.
Unfortunate scenes as a player seems to be injured for Isipathana. Let's see who the player is. Very unfortunate, because it's only the starting few minutes of the team. It's D.N. Vikramarachi, the number 8 for Isipathana. We really do hope that he's nothing serious is bothering him there. Replacement Bandara comes in, wearing the number 16 jersey in place of Rick Marachi. 5 minutes gone, Isipathana with a penalty, and it will be interesting to see what their call would be.
Lovely guests from Rohan Fernando. A salute to the player who walks out.
Please.
Very nice to see that from a referee.
Time on. The rug bomb.
Hands inside the rug. Trinity guilty of playing the ball inside the rug. Now Isipathana with a brilliant opportunity inside the Trinity 22 to set it up properly
and
try and put pressure on Trinity. They've opted to go for a full line out, all 8 men inside the line out.
Centre mark. No, yeah.
Earlier line out, Trinity opted not to contest, but they will try and put pressure on the Isipathanians here. Two separate pods already available for Isipathana, clearly available for Isipathana here. First pod and the second pod, with number 16 as the possible jumper. Opting to go to number 4. Decent defense by the Trinity forwards to stop that maul. Brick prop forward, Varnapura carrying the ball for Isipathana. Opting to go on the short side, and that's a very good tackle. Driving the ball carrier back. Now Isipathana sending the ball out wide, inside ball. And running through the ranks. Beautiful try by De Silva for Isipathana. Classic Isipathana in motion. Inside pass. The win three quarter, running circles, untouched, touches down underneath the post.
Yeah, that's what Manika Ruberu can do to you, isn't it? He held the ball for a couple of seconds extra. That made the defense think, because he's such a big unit and he can carry the ball with two to three players around. And then came the inside runner in the form of De Silva, who ran a beautiful running line and was a bit too late for Rashan Bandaranaike to cover in tackle. The try was good, conversion not that good, which has been the case for Isipathana so far this season. Conversions has been a problem. And from the start of play, Sudarshana, Isipathana have not left the Trinity half, and they come away with five points.
Oh, absolutely. For all the annexing that they did in the first few minutes of this game, they've come away with 5 points. Could have made it 7, but Isipathana will be glad that they have 5 points to show for all the domination that they had. Trinity, on the other hand, need to work at trying and playing as much rugby as they can in the opposite half, because they've been bogged down in their own half this entire game so far. 8 minutes has elapsed. Good high hanging kick, Isipathana right underneath it. Trinity tried to win that one, but loses the ball into the line out.
Good kickoff on that occasion. Good hang tag just away from the 10 meter line. Gave ample time for the chasers. First opportunity for Trinity College. A line out inside the opposition. Now let's see what they have in stock.
This was a problem area for Trinity against Zahira College. Their lineouts weren't functioning very well, especially during that second half. But this time around, no problem with the throw. Now going through the ranks is Karunanayaka. Good carry by him. Minidu gives it to Zaid. Back to Minidu. Skipper gives it to Dhanaraj, who's not able to hold on to the ball.
Keep it down, player.
Otherwise was running a very good line there.
Step back.
Knock forward advantage for Isipathana. That's a threatening kick. Bandaranaike struggling to get behind the ball. Did very well to make sure that he was out of danger. Amit Kulutunga, who was in support, has managed to salvage Trinity. Couple of meters. Now Tehan to Minidu. Minidu kicking for touch, and Trinity will take that.
Yeah, that pass not coming off Dhanaraj. Had he caught it, it would have been good momentum for Trinity. Now once again Isipathana have come and parked themselves inside the opposition half. Play still on the 22 meter mark. It'll be interesting to see. It's a 5-man line out that Isipathana is going to.
Stop. Half meter gunner. Kinagapara mama. Yapka close to the match is against him.
Trinity need to contest, and they win it.
Well done by the Trinity second rows, putting pressure, but Isipathana managing to retake that one. Now on to the defensive mode.
No head advantage.
Referee says no advantage, so he will bring back play. Trinity losing the ball forward. Isipathana with a scrum. That's been scrappy play from both teams in the opening few minutes of this game, Dinuk. Intense nevertheless, end-to-end stuff.
Looking for the ball, Pallekelle is a place where you lose a lot of balls because it goes out. Trying to attack on the open side, Isipathana, but there is no one on the blind side.
Goals.
Everyone is held up on the, is lined up on the open side.
Set.
It'll be interesting move if they break off on the blind side here.
Stay by.
It's a perfect opportunity too to do break off on the blind.
Be by.
Tehan covering that. Here's another threatening move of Isipathana. Good tackle by Tevin. He was held on.
That's going to be penalty all day long because the player who went down was held on by the tackler. So he needs to release the ball and come up. Minidu, interestingly, opting to kick to the win rather than trying to get the win advantage. Puts the ball to boot. That's a good high-hanging kick. But Amit Kulatunga is going to be in real trouble there. Trinity yet again guilty of not kicking the ball into touch clearly, and Amit Kulatunga will play the price with the minimum of a yellow card. He'll be lucky to get away from a red card because that player did look like he landed on his head.
Yeah, for sure, he was in the air as well. And that should be, I think that'll be a red. It's a big loss for Trinity.
We really do hope that the player is all right because that looked real nasty.
Are you okay?
Amit Kulatunga.
No, I see you, your scenario, you know, no dangerous in your head door. I see. Yeah.
Referee Fernando having a small chat with the player and the two physios who've arrived. Now Amit Kulatunga must be on pins to see which color
his head,
the card would be.
Head injury.
Player held up until the injured player is being attended to. So in these early exchanges, Dinuk, so far I think Isipathana have been the most promising team. They've been the ones who had possession to play with it. Trinity, on the other hand, have been guilty of not holding on to possession and especially guilty of not finding touch.
Yeah, interesting. Amit had a word with his forward, so he knows it's going to be a card. It's a matter of which card it is going to be.
It's
the second stretcher that has been brought out, and Isipathana.
So there you go, referee Fernando making his instructions very clear. If a player is not in, he can come back after the HIA. But if a player is replaced for him, he cannot come back into the game. It will be considered as an injury replacement. So for Isipathana's sake, and also player's sake. We really do hope that it's not a serious injury. Referee Fernando will have a word with his assistants as well to try and see what his assistants have spotted. Seems like from what we heard from the assistant referee, his recommendation was for a yellow card. On the other hand, Fernando, number 11 being called up. Amit Kulutunga has already taken off his headgear. Oh, he'll be very much relieved. Yellow card is all right. I can see that Dinuk is relieved as well. Most of the Trinity fans were dreading the red, the other color to come out, but yellow it is. So Kulutunga will only miss 10 minutes of the game. There's a strong wind blowing from the right to the left of your screen, so Isipathana, who are playing with the wind, will have to try and take maximum out of the first half that they have the wind assist, because like we've seen a couple of times, Trinity have found it very difficult to kick against the wind.
Yeah, true. That's why it was interesting. Even that kick on a normal day would have found touch, but because of the wind, it fell into the wintry quarter sand of Isipathana. That's where Minindu needs to come back to the near side, to the pavilion side, to kick. Play on. Here's Ruberu. Strong ball carrier, Manilka Ruberu. Isipathana still having ball in play. That's a long pass to the replacement, Gishapa, making the tackle on Chaminda, who's another ball, strong ball carrier. Isipathana, this time through Atuko Rala, going into contact. And that's Manoj taking the ball into contact. Moving forward, Isipathana. Here's another opportunity, sending it out wide to Sandaruan. Comes to Silva. Silva trying to play it close. A knock forward. And referee says play on. Trinity have managed to turn over ball. And it's been once again stolen by Atuko Rala. Referee playing advantage. Again, Trinity have stolen through their skipper, Rashan Bandaranaike. They need to kick it to the correct side this time around. Minindu. Yes, coming to the correct side again, but that will help. You saw Sudarshan, it was not a proper kick off the boot, but the wind helped it into touch.
Oh, absolutely, I think that's going to be crucial. And you'd expect Minindu to have studied those conditions, given that this is their home ground for Trinity. But Isipathana looking very threatening, and Trinity need to make sure that they capitalize on the chances that they receive. Isipathana, on the other hand, have a numerical advantage with them. Seems like number 14 for Isipathana, Ramit De Silva, who was the try scorer and had a nasty clash a little while earlier, is fit to go up on his feet. Overthrown, but Isipathana managing on to hold on to position. Trinity tackling has been strong, but what they have lacked at is trying to be physical around the fringes. Kick to space by the number 9 for Isipathana, but seems like it was slightly overcooked.
That's the space that was created with Amit Kulutunga's yellow card, Sudarshana. That's a good spot, but not well executed. So they'll take a scrum from where it was kicked. Option given if it was a 22-meter dropout or a scrum. And Ekanayaka correctly going for a scrum. He has plenty of experience, this guy, Ekanayaka.
Absolutely. A right call to be made because a 22 dropout would have meant that Trinity would have lost possession yet again. This time around, Trinity will be looking to try and create something. They haven't had possession much.
I think they need to run down the clock, Sudarshan, get Amit back because if they try to run off this scrum, it's going to be danger time because Isipathana is one man extra and they're very strong. They're back.
Number 8 break by Dhanaraj, who loses balance. Back to Minidu, who puts the ball right up. Not the ideal call, isn't it? Especially given the fact that you're man down. Beautiful offload to Charminder, who holds on to the ball but loses it forward. Trinity bouncing on the ball now. Luckily for them, it comes out their way. Ratwatte doing the halfback duties to Bandaranaike. Bandaranaike with the kick. Plenty of space on the outside for Isipathana. They can get the ball out. Ruberu breaks the first tackle. Now into space is the second center for Isipathana, number 13, Ratnayaka. Still going. Stopped inches away. Centimeters off the try line. Isipathana going for their second and will get it. Brilliant play by Isipathana. Manilka Ruberu, the man, touching down. And absolutely brilliant stuff. Trinity, second time around, they've been made to pay for bad kicking decision making. Dinuk, that time it was the skipper, but Trinity guilty of not realizing which corner to kick.
You have to find grass against this Isipathana team, Sudarshana. You can't kick to hand and expect them to not run the ball. These guys will run the ball all day if you kick to hand. They need to kick to grass, and that's something that is missing from this Trinity team. And interestingly, they're not taking the kicking, they're not taking the kicks from the base. They're going to the fly half to kick as well. So something those have to work on. And also, if they keep the ball within the tight five, play with the forwards, there's plenty of strength that you can expose out of this Isipathana team because they are not that big except for a couple of players.
Second conversion not successful for Isipathana, so the score line will remain at 10 points to nil. There'll be a lot of soul searching in that Trinity huddle. They don't know what has hit them. And referee Fernando,
doctor,
stopping the clock.
Others get back, please. Player okay, then.
Player okay, gahan bolo.
Player gahan bolo. Injury, head injury, make
it. Head injury, apni explode kara. He can play.
Gahan bolo. Injury, apni mukut mein. Right. Enang he can.
Very well done by referee Fernando, consulting the doctor, and the doctor giving the clearance that De Silva can come back into the game yet again. Player safety is of the highest importance to everybody involved in this game. Yet again, De Silva carrying the ball forward, still on the move. Trinity guilty of missing a couple of tackles there. Putting the ball to boot from the box is the Isipathana halfback Kalhara. Bandaranaike collected the ball inside the 22 and opted to kick it from outside the 22. Isipathana now has numbers on the outside. Gishap Kulatunga, wild swing of the ball. Very lucky it found one of his teammates. Referee now playing advantage to Trinity. for Isipathana coming in on from the side. This is the first time Trinity have managed to build a couple of faces. Very well defended there by the Isipathana defense. Still available, but
still advantage.
Not many players to support for Trinity College. Still playing advantage. Minidu now gives it to Bandar Naik, who's been bundled into touch. So good defensive work by Isipathana College, and the advantage was just over before Bandar Naik was bundled into touch.
Water break.
So that will be a water break. 22 minutes on the clock. Referee Fernando decides that it's too hot to wait for 13 more minutes. So we will take a quick break, and the Candy Battle of the Maroons, 130th big match with Kinsu taking on Dharmaraja on the 15th and the 16th of March at Pallekelle International Stadium. We will bring it to you live on www.thepapare.com. A very old big match there as well, which has crossed the 100 game mark over a decade ago. They know.
Interesting, all these big matches in Kandy, though they cross the 100 mark, they still keep on playing for 2 days.
Trinity will now have to put pressure on this line out from Isipathana and try and make sure they go into the half time at least with one score, because yes, they will have the wind advantage in the second half, you know, but that's not going to be enough.
You can't trust Pallekelle, Sudarshana. This will turn around totally other way around in a bit. It's that kind of a wind that you have here. But for the moment, it's towards the dressing room, a crosswind, which is in favor of Isipathana College.
Isipathana with the throw-in. Atukorala taking his own sweet time. That's a dummy for all day. Trinity forwards, the two prop forwards were very vocal there in the line-out. Free kick awarded to Trinity College, and they will opt to go for a scrum. It did work, isn't it? Didn't it, Dinoka? The two prop forwards talking to the hooker, telling him to throw it to him. Plays on the hooker's mind. Missed the jumper's call, and finally guilty of faking that throw. And seems like Kulatunga's 10 minutes are up in the naughty chair, so he will be introduced to this game after this scrum. Karuna Naika with the put in. Trinity opting to get it out on the first go, first face ball. Carrying the ball forward is Karuna Naika. Good defensive effort by Isipathana flanker. Now to Dhanaraj, yet again not managing to hold on to the ball. Tapped it twice. It was a little low on him, dipped on him. So Isipathanians coming away with possession. We look to clear their ranks. Taken outside the 22, so cannot kick it out in full. Bandar Naik now with the counter. Putting the ball into empty space, and that's a good kick by Bandar Naik. Now we will see a real battle here. The Trinitians will try to unsettle the Isipathana hooker yet again. They succeeded the last time, Will there be a second time lucky? We will have to wait and see. Isipathana, on the other hand, need to make sure that they talk to their hooker, tell him to settle down. We'll go for a basic two-man number two jump, or they can opt to go for the front pail until the hooker gets his confidence back on.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see where they'll throw. Referee also, I think, clearly warning their forwards not to waste time on the lineup. There's plenty of time wasted.
Wait.
Trying to slow down the game, Isipathana. And when they have space, they just burn pace. This time going right.
Isipathana setting it up. Fairly good defensive effort by the Trinitians, managing to hold on to the initial surge, but Isipathana still on the move in that mall. Looking good. Now they will have to get the ball out. It's available for the Isipathana scrum half, who puts the ball to boot from the base. Kulatunga right underneath it. Has plenty of redemption to do. And straight away gets in on it. Tamit Kulatunga knows that he owes the team 10 minutes. Big carry by the Trinity. Prop forward, Ekanayaka. Now to Minidu. Gives it to Robinson. Kulatunga cut him back inside. Why did he have to go right inside the same ruck? His teammate was tackled on. Luckily, Trinity coming away with a penalty advantage. Sending it out wide, Ekanayaka has been a strong ball carrier for Trinity College so far. Minidudu Bandaranayaka gives it to Karuna Nayaka, has two numbers on the outside. Kulatunga. Trinity is still with ball. Need to set it up and get their numbers right. There is a massive gap in the middle of the Trinity attacking formation. Now Dhanaraj, brilliant offload, needs support. Trinity have numbers on the outside. Skipper going in. Now his deputy, Ratwatte, carrying the ball forward. Janidu, cross field kick, goes full out. I'm trying to think what the thinking was there. Dinuk trying to kick it cross field. Would have been ideal if he could have put it behind the Isipathana defensive line so that his charges could have attacked that ball. But Trinity building some interesting faces, but giving it away cheaply.
Yeah, true, Sudarshana. So much forwards gaining momentum here. Not sure why that ball went to the back and went for a cross kick. Here is Isipathana now. They are line out through at the same place for the third time now. Tapped back by Trinity. Taken by Tehan. Going into contact is Munasinghe. Here is Ekanayaka giving it to Minindu to go into contact. This is Tavin. Oh, it's straight into the basket of the Isipathana. 13 Ratnayaka. That's the easiest try he'll ever score. And that'll put down the confidence levels of Trinity College.
Third try for Isipathana. Manu Ratnayaka touching down. Now that one was an overdue Christmas present from Trinity. Nicely wrapped with a card saying thank you for visiting us. But cardinal error. Isipathana now in the driving seat. Nobody would have expected this goal when they came into this game. But Isipathana clearly dominating Trinity College. Trinity haven't had proper position this entire game, and I'm sure Isipathanians are jubilant. Massive crowd making their way to Candy, and their third time lucky, managing to get the conversion. So Isipathana lead 17 points to nil with only a couple of minutes left in this first half. Trinity, on the other hand, the home team in real trouble. Has been the story for Candy teams this weekend. Started off with the Antonians surrendering to St. Joseph's in the second game. Kensud College losing out to St. Peter's 7 points to 14. And Trinity College here trailing 17 points to nil with only a couple of minutes remaining in this first half. Can they get a score under their name? We will have to wait and see. But so far it has been all green in this encounter. Isipathana dominating the Trinitians. Isipathana in the early exchanges were guilty of not holding on to possession, but have taken the maximum out of the chances that they got. Bandar Nayaka for Trinity, trying to instate a counter. Minidu gives it to Robinson, to Kulatunga. Can he go all the way, running down the flank? 5 meters to go. Kishap Kulatunga will touch down. That's the comeback try Trinity were looking forward to. And they hit back through a counter from nowhere. Kishap Kulatunga should have maybe, just maybe, cut back inside and look for that easier kicking angle. But try is a try for Trinity, and they will take that.
Sudarshan, and this is why I was wondering why he was cutting back inside, because he has space to burn on the outside. And if you can run around an Isipathana win three quarter like that, why do you have to cut back inside? That shows you how much space you have. Gishapa has shown class before. He needs to get his head space right. If he gets it, he could score plenty of tries this season. So much talent in this guy.
I'm sure that try would have given him a lot of confidence, and a lot of confidence to all the Trinity fans and the players as well. Now it's up to Minidu to go out into the half time with the heads high if he can try and convert this one. We've seen that he has done a small tweak to his kicking run up. Reminds me of Javed Tanveer, the way he bowls. There you go, a little goose step, hop step, kicks it off the post. So the score will remain at 5 points to 7.
Yeah, that's not an easy kick. He was kicking right where the wind is coming off. So if you're wondering on screen where the wind is coming off, that's where exactly the wind is coming. He was kicking straight against the wind.
Right into the wind. But Trinity will be glad that they are going into the game with a score. Five points to 17. Isipathana still in the driving seat. Here's the halfback for Isipathana, Kalhara. Handed the restarting responsibilities. Good high hanging kick. Trinity lucky to hold on to it. Minidu will be looking for a little better angle from his clearance. But yet again, manages to find touch just outside the 22 meters. Number three, Now Isipathana with the line out just outside the 22 meters. We'll have to put pressure on the hooker by opting to jump, going to number four. That time the throw was good. Manilka Rubero yet again breaking off the first tackle. Plenty numbers on the outside for Isipathana, but the pass is not good. Still on the move though. Now the Greens changing direction on to the open side. Carrying the ball forward is Atukural, the hooker for Isipathana College. Have options on either side. Here's Ratnayaka carrying it forward for Trinity College. And that's a loss forward. So Trinity will be glad to get out of jail. They look, since their kicking hasn't paid off well, do you think they should take the risk and run from their own 22, go to the open side and try and create something from that side? Because the empty area of the field behind Isipathana defense is on the open side, because their kicking time and time again haven't been up to the mark so far.
I think a number 8 break here would be good. That's where they'll gain momentum moving forward, and then the forwards can rally around.
Yes, Dhanaraj haven't had the best of games so far. Couple of handling errors. Yes, Dhanaraj breaking from the short side. Ball out to Gishap Kulatunga, who stepped on the touchline. A little bit of a bromance. Some margi-bargi is natural in a full contact game, and that's half time. 5 points to 17. Interesting first half. Dinuk Isipathana College, clearly the dominant team in the first half. Trinity, on the other hand, has a lot of work to do.
A lot of work to do. I think it's just simple. Keep the ball with the forwards. Create momentum there, because that's where they're gaining a lot of meters. Whereas Isipathana, their backs are dominating. And don't kick to hand. Don't kick to the 11, 15 and 14. Halftime confirmation, 17 points to 5, Isipathana College leading against Trinity College.
To be a man is to sweat for every last inch of it. The harder you push yourself, the louder your body will protest. From sweat to grease, grease to dandruff. Fight back with Clear Men, two times the fighting power of ordinary shampoos. Beat grease, beat dandruff. Unbeatable performance for the unbeatable man. Power through the odds. Clear, zero dandruff, nothing to hide.
Discover fashion inspired by emotion. Glitz, the fashion destination.
Then Goldio body spray hathunwaden alut marut madili athrakin blaze challenge storms are rave athuma try karanna Goldio body spray pevisi athrapura.
කිසි ගැම්මක් නැහැ. පදම පරක්කු ඇයි?
සුමීරි පානේ පදමට ගහලා දවස පුරා ගතට දැනෙන මිහිරක් බුබුදා.
හොඳම මැලිබන්තේ.
කහට පදම නියමෙට රස සමගමු සූනා. මැලිබන්තේ එක්ක අපේ දවස රස වුණා.
පදම වරුනේ.
කහට පදම නියමෙට රස සමගමු සූනා.
මැලිබන්තේ පදමට කහට.
Sri Lankika Samage Therima, no limit.
Kisi gammak ne, padama parakku ei.
Sumiri paane, padamata gahala. Davasa pura gatata danena mihirak bubuda.
Hondama malibante.
Kahata padama niyameta rasa samagamu suna.
Melibon Tika Ape Lavasa Rasa Muna
Padama Varune
Padama Niyamita Rasa Samagam Sumuna
Melibon Tika Padamata Kahata
I have news. Let's meet.
Find yourself in love. Fashion inspired by emotion. Glitz, the fashion destination.
When she's special, she's not just a girlfriend. She is your sweetheart. When you feel it, you don't just call it sunshine, you call it warmth. When you reveal your deepest emotions, it's not just art, it's freedom. And when its essence is premium cocoa butter, it's not just chocolate, it's Ravello. Chocolate so special, you call it Ravello.
Langarandi nama
Sana sumadana nama
Eya singa nama
Sri Lanka
මාතර කොටවිල ගම්පියසට ඇවිල්ලා තියෙනවා.
සිට දාස
ඇට් මොරටුව
පියගම මහින්ද රාජපක්ෂ ක්‍රීඩාංගණය.
කිලක්කු මහන.
සුගත දාස ඉන්ඩෝ ස්ටේඩියම්
is the Fox Hill Supercross.
රුණ
Nagala City, Athugal Puravare.
Papare.com api adavili ni Noorelia Pradesh.
Final showdown, Candy Sports Club.
Purnarwe, Jatik Sankirne City.
Welcome back to the live action brought to you from the Pallekelle Trinity College Rugby Stadium on Sri Lanka's number one sports hub, www.thepapare.com. Papare.com celebrating 10 years of sharing the passion this year. And we have a terrific game on our hands. Isipathana currently in the lead, 17 points to Trinity's 5. And the Pathanians, the visiting team, has definitely been the most dominant team in the early exchanges.
Yeah, Isipathana, a couple of good tries they scored. Superb moves. One of course, an intercepted try. But Isipathana did everything right in that first half. It's an opportunity for Trinity now. Minindu Jayasundara.
Captain.
Interesting
Captain
to see where he will kick off this time.
Trinity has made a change in Mahdi Abdullah coming into the game. Playing his first few minutes. Here's Minindu Jayasundara breaking away. Trying to offload. Lost it out. Very unfortunate there. Similar to Isipathana in the opening minutes of the game.
Trying to clear it out. This is the problem. Now you see how Isipathana is finding hard to kick. They have to kick it to the near side. And he has a perfect opportunity. Use the pack weight now. The rolling maul on the cards, because Trinity have plenty of weight in that forwards, Sudarshana.
But remember, when it comes to the line outs, the wind also plays a huge role. So they need to make sure they get their line out jump right. Opting to go to the front. Trinity setting it up. Needs to be careful about the touch line. Isipathana doing well to defend that ball. Couple of hands inside that ruck. Referee Fernando decides that it's okay. Jayasundara trying to break through the middle. But well defended by Isipathana. Trinity sending it out now to Karuna Nayaka. Well marked. Now to the short side.
On your feet, number 5, red. On your feet.
Okay, Seka Nayaka going into contact.
Roll away, green.
To Tehan. Now it's Zaid. Standing off one tackle. Brings two to bring him down. Here is Minindu to Tevin Robinson. Twisting and turning Robinson. Stepping off one. Gives it to Tevin. And he knocks the ball forward.
Terrible ball handling skills there. Had both his hands up. His palms turned away from his body. That time Karuna Nayaka, I think, was a little unsettled to collect that pass, but two opportunities going begging for Trinity College. And there seems to be an injury to Isipathana player.
Plenty of injury concerns for Isipathana today.
Fernando not happy with the formation of the scrum. Wants it reset.
Crouch.
Trinity will be hoping to put Bye. Pressure on this scrum.
Set. Steady. Stop. Stop. Stop.
Use it.
Is
Isipathana under pressure, and they opt to go to touch. Trinity College with a line out inside the Isipathana red zone. So it will be interesting to see what they will opt to do. They tried setting it up on the other end of the field, which didn't quite come their way. Yet again, I believe they will try to set this one up as well. Opting to go for the full line out.
Stop.
And another swap coming in. Minindu Jayasundara has been taken out. And in comes R.M. Subasinghe to that very important number 10 position as the first 5-8. Trinity with the throw, and this time it's good. Coming out on the first space, Karuna Nayaka back to Subasinghe. Space on the outside, Rishan Bandar Nayaka gives it out, and Trinity almost at the line. Have they dropped it forward? Yes, they have. Lost forward and not playing to the referee's whistle against the run of play. Here's Isipathana going all the way. Goes underneath the post, and that will be a try for Isipathana College. The bonus point try right underneath the post. Referee will have a word with his assistants before awarding the try. Referee Fernando wanting to check for assistant referee with the try, and decides to award the try for Isipathana College. Completely against the run of play, and that try definitely would have sinked the hearts of the Trinitians, who were in very good motion in the build-up to that incident. But Isipathana clearly now in the driving seat, collecting their bonus point try, 22 points, and with the conversion it will be increased to 24. And Trinity are in deep trouble.
Yeah, against the run of play, that Trinity not playing to the referee's whistle there. Yes, there was a knock on, but good work from referee Fernando after he allowed the play to go on, consulted with Ishan Kabekon on the far side, and then awarded the try.
And here's the reply from Isipathana. Bandar Nayaka trying to break through the middle. Good carry by Hing, straightening things up for Trinity. Now Weka Nayaka. Good ball carrier he's been for Trinity College. Isolated this time. Luckily it comes away for Trinity. Bandar Nayaka gives it to Yaswant. Now ball going out to Ratwatte. Ratwatte still on his feet, looked for someone to offload, but there was no one there. Trinity opting to go on the short side. Need support. Seem to have found a new life, Trinity. Abdullah. Into the 22 meters. Zaid under a lot of pressure. Now to Eka Nayaka, gives it to Karna Nayaka. Straight into Ruberu. Isolated man, Dhanaraj. Has 22 meters. Nobody to support. Luckily, Kulatunga had the good sense to go and support his big number 8. Karna Nayaka. To Yaswant. Back to the 22 meters. Subasinghe. Long cutout pass to Bandar Nayaka. Numbers on the outside for Trinity. Ratwatte should have given it out, but Trinity recycle face ball, and that will be the second try. Rasin Bandar Nayaka touching down, and Trinity showing signs of a comeback. Touching down for the second try. Now they will try to make sure that they keep this momentum on, because every time either of the teams, when they hold on to possession and build faces, they look absolutely stunning.
Yes, exactly. And if they can keep error free, Trinity College can score a lot of points because their structure is good. They are playing a beautiful game of rugby, but the ball has to go into hand, and they need to get the field positions right, the players right. Catching and passing is crucial.
With Benito being taken out, Rashin Bandar Naik has been handed the responsibility of taking the conversions. Skipper. Bandar Naik will be looking to try and add 2 points. Good distance and height on the kick, but the direction was not right. So 10 points to 24, 14 point deficit as Trinity College score their second try. Isipathana have already secured a bonus point. They are the group leaders currently with their win in the opening game with a bonus point. Trinity in second. But the next 30 minutes will be absolutely crucial to both these teams. Isipathana opting to go deep with their restart into the 22 meters. Tehan kicking the ball, not finding touch. This is where Isipathana is dangerous. Trinity have to make sure that their defensive lines are intact. No one behind, lucky bounce of the ball. Tehan now offloads to Karnanayake. Karnanayake. Can he go all the way? Has support, couldn't offload. Bandar Naik with a quick pick and go. Trinity now strong. Karnua Naik sniping through. Trinity need to try and get the ball out because they have plenty numbers on the open side. Yaswant carrying the ball forward for Trinity. Huge overlap. Ratwatte cutting back inside. Didn't look for the pass, but Trinity with possession. Super Singh, a long cutout pass. And that will be Trinity's third try. And are we witnessing a comeback? We will have to wait and see. But Keshav Kulatunga collects his second try of the game. And Trinity getting their third try. And Keshav Kulatunga's second. This conversion is going to be absolutely crucial, Denuk, because they are inching close to that Isipathana mark. But remember, they are 14 points down. So if they can get this conversion right, it will be another converted try away from the Isipathana score, or else they will have to score twice in order to get there.
Yeah, true. That's why I said just before that, after that previous try was scored, you can see how good Trinity ball in that error-free. That error-free word has to be highlighted. If they can hold on to this, and they are putting a lot of pressure on Isipathana on the back foot now. If they can hold on to this momentum, it's going to be a good game on our hands here for sure.
Bandar Naik's kick kept low. So conversion not successful. So the score will remain at 15 points to 24. Isipathana now with a 9-point lead. What a game we've had so far. You know, 7 tries scored. Isipathana College will be looking to capitalize on what the good work they've done. Not the ideal start they would have looked for. So center field scrum for Trinity.
Centre back.
Very important possession for Trinity College. They have options on either side of the field.
Couch! Bind! Set! Steady! Steady!
Karuna Nayaka to put in.
Be bind!
Dhanaraj to Karuna Nayaka. Gives it out to Subha Singh. Subha Singh on the run. Gishap Kulatunga. And Trinity penalized for holding on to the ball. Kulatunga was isolated. Had no choice but to hold, try and hold on to it. I think
play
the game
will
the game will be held up for a couple of minutes. I think one of the spectators has had a small trouble. He's been they're trying to take him out. Referee has to stop play because the ambulance is on the field. Here's Isipathana with an opportunity
14.
To try and get into the Trinity half. Not the ideal kick, but Isipathana will be happy that they've found touch. And Trinity now need to make sure that they try and capitalize. Put Isipathana under a lot of pressure from here. Really do hope that the spectator who needs medical assistance is all right. Isipathana with the throw-in, just meters away from the 50-meter mark. Front peel, well defended by Trinity. Read it thoroughly and bundle them into touch. So riding on the momentum of that two quick tries, Trinity College is looking to make sure that they inch closer to the Isipathana score of 24 points. 9-point deficit to be countered. Referee Fernando not happy with the two lines making the mark. We'll have a word with the back leader and the man at the back to make sure that they're straight.
No, nothing wrong.
On to the second pot. No problem, says the referee. Short ball to the Trinity center, Karuna Nayaka, now going on the short side. Trintians have used that short side to very good effect so far this game. Losing that ball forward under pressure. Good defensive work by Isipathana, managing to unsettle the halfback.
The interceptor try could come back to haunt Trinity. About 18 minutes on our clock.
Mark here.
Replacements are coming thick and fast for Trinity College.
Dahatak gila din. Hariya pariya me. Cramp ekad mad match ekad namatte ke niye babu darai.
Tantirige coming in for Yashwant, who seems like suffering with a calf injury. slowly making his way out of the field.
Set, steady. Oh, no, behind.
Good pressure from Trinity in that scrum, putting Isipathana under pressure. Patani is opting to put the ball to boot. Bandar Naika had to kick it out, was under pressure. Now Trinity in danger zone. Isipathana into the 22 meters of Trinity College. Yet again, will their line-out woes come back to haunt them? We will have to wait and see. Trinity have done very well when it comes to defensive lineouts so far. This time collected cleanly in the second, and they've lost it forward. Isipathana, they set it up well. Frustration inside the forwards. Whenever their line out works well, their maul doesn't. So that's going to be very crucial to try and get that into motion, the Isipathana line outs.
Yeah, true, and a crucial scrum here for Trinity Sudarshan. And they do get the ball out into the Isipathana half.
Coach!
With a new fly half in, it'll be interesting to see who will take the kicking duties.
Mama Balanna,
Mata Kauru Tugannan Dona, because both teams are pushing before.
Indepa Athulata, right? Mark here.
The referee's call.
Crouch. Bind. Set. Steady.
Here's Tehan feeding the ball into the scrum. Good forward momentum. His brother Tevin taking the ball into the line.
Release.
That's good from Trinity, hitting up.
Play on!
And now Tehan will put the kick. It stays in the field of play. The chase needs to be on. It's locked backwards. Here's Amit now taking the ball into contact. Opportunity for Trinity College. No advantage. It'll be a scrum.
I think there Tehan missed a trick to Dinuk. He had numbers on the open side. Trinity were playing with advantage. He should have tried giving it out. Worst come to worst, it would have come back to them.
Prabhat coming in for Trinity College. Another change. Rahul Dhanaraj taken out. Hasn't had a good game. Had a superb season opener. But today is not as his best. Rahul Dhanaraj, a big unit.
Absolutely a big fine for Trinity. Big made number 8. Didn't have the best of games for today. But we'll be looking to make sure that he capitalizes from the mistakes. Injury concerns piling up for Isipathana. Another player being carried off. Number 8 break on the short side for Trinity. Looking to slow things up. And here's an up and under. Pressure on to the kicker. Good defensive work by Super Singh, who was on that man quickly. Trinity defense need to make sure that they reorganize. Need to get numbers on to the open side. Isipathana is on the other hand, trying to take the direct route with their forwards coming into play. Here's Kalhara with a kick to touch. A lovely step by Kulatunga. Brilliant stuff running around. Great vision of where the defender was. Now Wekanayaka. gives it to the replacement, Nandisena. Karuna Nayaka was found flat-footed there. Numbers on the open side for Trinity. Bandar Nayaka to Ratwatte. Ratwatte should have given it out. Third time he's not given the ball out. Now to Nandisena. Yaswant met with a big defensive tackle by the Isipathanians. Ekanayaka gives it out to Robinson. Robinson now plenty numbers. Kulatunga cutting back inside. Very wise move that. Now to Nandisena, who drops the ball square. Unforced errors will be frustrating Trinity now. Couple of Isipathana players down on the ground. And we have approximately 17 minutes to go in this game. Anything can happen. We are coming close to a very interesting final 10 minutes of this game, Dinuk.
Yeah, true. It's just a couple of scores here and there for both teams.
Camp there.
And Trinity trying to empty their bench.
Camp change karan. Navatang ninda back camp.
Fresh legs is needed on the park.
Time on.
Amit taken out.
Mark here.
Except for the yellow card, I think he has had a fantastic match.
Sri Lanka tour of South Africa 2019. You can visit www.thepapare.com/cricket/SAVSL to find out all the insights about the game. Today, Sri Lanka will be playing their third ODI. Currently,
South Africa 331 for 5 in 50 overs. Big chase in Durban.
Durban has always been happy hunting grounds for Sri Lanka, so they will be looking for a repeat of that performance in the test series. But Trinity College at that time Referee Fernando clearly saw something. Will want to have a word. Will clearly want to have a word with the assistant referee. Seems like there was some foul play on the number 14, RSD Silva.
He's the same player who had an hand injury on the other side. I don't think he's fit to play, referee Fernando.
Number 9, captain. Number. You kicking head. Yeah, it's a red card.
That's a red card. Kicking the head. Tehan Karuna Nayaka will not play any part of this game, and Trinity will be reduced to 14 men for the remainder of the game.
Time on. Time. Putting.
Tehan found guilty of kicking, and it landed on the head of another player. So Trinity dealt with a big blow, and rightly so. Isipathana College opting to go for 3 points, trying to steer away from the Trinitians. 14 against 15. Anyways, Trinity had a uphill task to try and get to that 9 points in the final 10 minutes of play, but now it's become even more difficult.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. Trinity will have to make a change, bring in Danindu here at that scrum half, because Tehan was servicing so well, and just the rush of blood. Good kick, trying to run from their own half and kick. This is not something that you will want to do for Isipathana. Ball is coming out wide. Here is Isipathana once again, now up in momentum. Trinity one man short. Going into contact. Up in defense once again. Holding on.
Trinity defending desperately. They know that they are one man short. And Isipathana trying to really put this game to rest. Well, 50-50 call there because that player had his... yes, there you go. He had the right
number
to
one.
The ball, but he couldn't support his own body weight. Had a hand on the ground. So, Isipathana will yet again opt to go for 3 points from 40 meters out. Ribeiro has a better angle now, right in front of the post. But credit should be given to Isipathana for the way they've played this game. They've taken all their chances with both hands except for those early unforced errors that they faced.
Yeah, true. And Manilka Ribeiro has played an immense part of that in controlling that back line. If you see all those tries scored, Sudarshana, it's him who has created that impact inside. This time going in between the posts, it's through. Trinity will rush things now. It's 27 points to 15. They need to score two converted tries to come back in this game. It's not going to be easy. Kick has been made to the center field once again, straight to the hand, to the scrum half, and he kicks it back. This is very good from Isipathana College, playing in Trinity territory. Yes, Bandar Nayaka trying to cut back in. Accelerates and goes into contact just outside the 22. Kick once again into the win three quarters hand. Now look at this lineup on the far side. Three players already. This is where he's dangerous off. And that'll be a penalty again. Referee playing advantage. Just putting a lethargic hand out the Trinitians. That'll be advantage over. Taken back. Because the ball hit the ground, that was enough in advantage. He has an opportunity now. Going into contact is Ratwatha. Going to need to find a scrum half. Without a scrum half, they're playing. Here's Yashwant. Macon Yashwant taking the ball into contact. Everybody chipping in here. The big prop forward. Referee playing advantage once again. It'll be a penalty. And that'll be another yellow card. To Atukorala, a key member in Isipathana. 7 minutes to go on our clock, Sudarshana. He will not play any part in this game. This is the opportunity for Trinity College.
Numbers evened out now. 14 against 14. But 12 points in front. Isipathana will consider themselves this game theirs to lose. In the final 10 minutes of the game, Trinity College reduced to 14 men due to that red card on Tehan Karunanayake. Now Trinitians with an opportunity. They need to make sure that they get this right. Nandi Sena with the throw-in. That's a good throw, but equally well contested by Isipathana, who are on the charge now. Isipathana running to the corner. Trinity defense need to scramble now. The halfback with a wild offload. Trinity managing to win it. Ball still available for the Trinitians. Bandaranaike's kick finds touch right on the mark. It would have been full out otherwise, because it was taken back into the 22 meters.
Sudarshana, Rashan Bandaranaike is playing his heart out. He's kicking, he's playing as a scrum half. Now when turns up as a physio, coming and supporting Indrax. If Trinity wins this game, it'll be his match. If not, I think Isipathana have done a fantastic job so far in this game.
I think it's going to be, if we are to name a man of the match, Dinuk, if you are to name a man of the match, I think it's a toss-up between Bandaranaike and Ruberu. Whoever wins it will take it home. Isipathana with a line out, and the injuries are piling in. Unfortunately for them, number 10, RG De Silva, seems to be a little phased. The doctor does not want him to continue playing because he needs to be assisted.
My decision is he's confused.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Referee Fernando that time doing the right thing.
Please.
Player will insist that he wants to play, but referee clearly indicating head injury. He has to go out, and a replacement needs to come back in. De Silva clearly not agreeing with the referee, but sometimes the player himself will not realize the danger that he is in. So very well done by referee Fernando that time. Isipathana opting to go for a five-man line out here. Ruberu with a good high-hanging kick. Trinidians underneath it, trying to run on the outside, running around, and loses his footing due to an ankle tap. That was number 25 for Trinity. Moragoda. Unfortunate for him and the Red Gold Blues.
Points to 15. Not much time on the clock now. That 3 points which Ruberu took and scored was a superb move by Isipathana. Here's Isipathana attacking. Ruberu steps into the 10-meter, number 10 slot, and you can see he wants to play in the Trinity half, and he's putting a lot of pressure in the Trinitians. Here's the win three-quarter, stepping in and trying to run on his own, needs support. Bandaranaike comes in once again in support. He's picking and driving because he doesn't have enough support on his back in the form of his forwards. Going to the short side.
Trinity still looking for that elusive that was gifted to them. Now Bandaranaike to Yaswant. Padnekanaike that time. Big boy, big carry. A number one still carrying the ball forward. Nice to see. Here's the replacement, number 8. Well tackled by the Isipathana defender. Ekanaike again. Grass cutter on him. Puts him on the field. Inside ball. Meddled with it but managed to hold on. Trinity have been bogged down in the same place for a while now. Madi Abdullah gaining a couple of meters. That's going to be a penalty in favor of Trinity College, coming in from the sides. Isipathana There was no way they were going to win that ball from there. Bandar Naika taking it quickly. Opts to go on the short side. Eka Naika, what a game this boy is having. Denok, being a prop forward, is all around the park. Trinity with the penalty advantage yet again. They're really struggling without the service of a scrum half. Robinson carrying the ball into the Isipathana defense. Subasinghe now gives it to the big ten cone. Long pass to Abdullah. Cuts back inside. Should have given it outside. Had four men on his right shoulder. And that's a penalty for killing the ball in the ruck. Corinthians didn't allow it to come out. Isipathana bench pointing to the clock. 1 minute remaining in this game. So it's safe to say Isipathana will take the big W, Dinuk. And I think there will be no argument if we decide on Manik Ruberu as the man of the match. He's been outstanding. He will be the clear man of the match, who's been absolutely amazing for Isipathana College. They've been brilliant as Trinity try and get on to this mark. Carry by Pannavala. Ekanayaka cries for it to be sent it out, but referee Fernando whistles full time, so that's a win for Isipathana in their second encounter as well. 27 points to 15, second bonus point victory, and Trinity handed their first defeat of the season.
Yeah, it is, but I think Trinity can take a lot of heart out of this, because they didn't give up till the last motion. Of course, the structures were here and there. They have a lot of overlaps which could have been used, and it was Trinity's game to lose. That intercept try and that initial bust that gave away for Isipathana, that they won the game. But a gutsy performance from Isipathana College. They have come back and they came back. They had the lead from the front and held on to it throughout. There you go, confirmation. 27 points to 15. Isipathana taking it home at Pallekelle. So after a couple of years, Isipathana managed to come back with a win against the Trinitians.
Absolutely, Dinuk. What a performance by the men in green. They were up to the game. They were up to it from the get-go. The three tries in the first half, I think, costed Trinity. Especially that last try in the dying stages of the first half, which was gifted, which was an interception. That would have played at the back of the Trinitians. But this is what we play for, isn't it? Great camaraderie between the both teams. Hugging each other out. They fought like warriors, but soon after, they are very good friends. Isipathana supporters also make the way to Kandy in numbers, and have been such a terrific crowd getting behind their team no matter wherever they travel. And that's the stat card for you. Three tries scored by Trinity, four by Isipathana. Isipathana managing to convert two of their four tries, and that penalty, the difference between the two teams. At halftime, Isipathana led 5 points to 17. Come second half, it was Trinity who managed to get two tries, but the final score line reads 15 points to 27, with Manil Karubelu elected as our clear man player of the match of this game.
So fixtures coming up, the big one, Battle of the Blues, just ended yesterday in favour of St. Thomas's. Tomorrow it'll be in Mount Lavinia between Royal and St. Thomas's College. That's the only fixture that will be for the final for this week. And then the next week, Trinity will be taking on. So that's the end of the coverage here in Pallekkale. From Sudarshan Appearance, Dinuk Bhaskaran and the Papare technical crew, good night and congratulations to Isipathana College.
To be a man is to sweat for every last inch of it. The harder you push yourself, the louder your body will protest. From sweat to grease, grease to dandruff. Fight back with Clear Men, two times the fighting power of ordinary shampoos. Beat grease, beat dandruff. Unbeatable performance for the unbeatable man. Power through the odds. Clear, zero dandruff, nothing to hide.
දැන් යහපෝෂ දන්නේ ඉරිඟු සහල් මුං සෝයා විතරක් නෙවෙයි කිරිත් එකතු කරලා ඒ නිසා මා චේන්ජ් වුණා
ලංකාවේ ළමයින්ගේ අලුත්ම සෝයා ගැනීම මේක රසයක බැලිබන් යහපෝෂ රසයකට චේන්ජ් වෙන්න
කිසි ගැම්මක් නැහැ පදම පරක්කුවේ
සුමීරි පානේ පදමට ගහලා දවස පුරා ගතට දැන්නෙන මිහිරක් බුබුදා
හොඳම මැලිබන්තේ
පහට පදම නියමෙට රස සමගම සූනා මැලිබන්තේ එක අපේ දවස රස වුණා
පදම වරුනේ
පහට පදම නියමෙට රස සමගම සූනා
මැලිබන්තේ පදමට කහට
Stumble upon a surprise. Fashion inspired by emotion. Glitz, the fashion destination. Sri Lankika Samage Therima, no limit.
The most anticipated school rugby league is back in action. Witness the match-winning tries. Heart-stopping tackles. Moments that will take you to the edge of your seat. Experience the road to greatness. Catch the Singer League 2019 live exclusively on Dialog Television, channel number
77.
කිසි ගැම්මක් නැහැ පදම පරක්කු ඇයි
සුමීරි පානේ පදමට ගහලා දවස පුරා ගතට දැන්නෙන මිහිරක් බුබුදා
හොඳම මැලිබන්තේ
පහට පදම නියමෙට රස සමගම සූනා මැලිබන්තේ එක අපේ දවස රස වුණා
පදම වරුනේ
පහට පදම නියමෙට රස සමගම සූනා
මැලිබන්තේ පදමට කහට
දැන් යහපෝෂ දන්නේ ඉරිඟු සහල් මුං සෝයා විතරක් නෙවෙයි කිරිත් එකතු කරලා ඒ නිසා මා චේන්ජ් වුණා
ලංකාවේ ළමයින්ගේ අලුත්ම සෝයා ගැනීම මේක රසයක බැලිබන් යහපෝෂ රසයකට චේන්ජ් වෙන්න
Discover Fashion inspired by emotion Glitz, the fashion destination Sri Lankika Samage Therima, no limit.
When she's special, she's not just a girlfriend. She is your sweetheart.
When you feel it, you don't just call it sunshine. You call it warmth. When you reveal your deepest emotions, it's not just art. It's freedom. And when its essence is premium cocoa butter, it's not just chocolate. It's Ravello. Chocolate so special, you call it Ravello.
Langarendi Nama
Sana Samadena Nama
Eya Singa Nama
Nihira Mavana Nama
Avasani Vana Nama
Senehe Vedana Nama
Eya Singa Nama
Paulette Satuta Sadhana Singer at the Vishishta Vishwasaya.